We are discussing the examples of your chapter number 15, your example number 8 from page 246. Speed is given to you. You have to draw the time distance graph for the given speed. Beta, look here. Your question is time distance graph. One important concept I'm going to tell you is time distance. So this is your x, this is your y. So time you will take on your x axis and distance you will take on your y axis. Got it? Is it okay, beta? So time you will take on your x axis and the distance, Pranchi. And the distance you will take on your y axis. Now, look here, we have the formula. We have formula. Speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance is equal to speed into time. Is your formula? Distance is your d that I have written. Speed is 30 kilometer and time is t. So this is your expression, or you can say this is your equation. So now listen. We know that we have to draw the graph, and in case of the graph, you have to take x or y. So let's suppose your distance, let distance as y and time as x. So your y is equal to 30x is your equation. This is your equation, or you can say this is your expression. Got it, beta? So this relation, or you can say this can be your relation also. So this is the relation or equation, or you can say this is the expression for your x and y. And for this expression, you will draw the graph. Got it? Now, this can be your equation or expression, or you can say this is your relation. Relation between x and y. Now you have to draw the graph for this relation. Now you will draw the graph. For the graph, you need three values for your x and three values for your y. So let's draw this table. This is your x, this is your y. If you put value of x as 1, then value of y is your 30. If you put 1 here, so 30 into 1 will give you 30. If you put x as 2, so 30 into 2 will give you 60. If you put x is equal to 3, then 30 into 3 will give you 90. So this is your table. And for these three values, you will plot the graph. Now let's start with the graph. For this, you will plot your x-axis and y-axis. This is your x-axis. This is your y-axis. This horizontal line is called your x-axis. This vertical line is your y-axis. And the point of intersection of both will call origin, and its coordinate is 0, 0. Now, you will plot these values of 1, 2, and 3. So this is your 1. This is in R. And this distance is in kilometer. Got it? So you have to write the unit. So I'm writing here time. And time is in R. And distance is in kilometer. So let's write the detail about the x-axis and y-axis that I've written. Now take the value of x as 1, 2, 3, and 4. Value of y is your 30, 60, 90. As you can see that we are having the equal gap of 30. So let's start from 30, 60, then 90, and yes, is there need to put the king here? Do we need to put the king here? No, because equal gap is there. So no need to put the gap. And on, in case of x-axis, again, no need is there to put the king because equal gap is there. Now let's start with your graph. So for the one, for x equal to 1, you have y equal to 30. X 1, y 30, this is your point of intersection. For x 2 and y 60, this is your point. For x 3 and y 90, this is your third point. So this is your line graph, or you can say linear graph. And if you want to write the coordinate, you can write in the bracket 1, 30, 2, 60, 3, 90, and one more thing is pending. You will write the scale here. For x-axis, you have scale as one box is equal to, for x-axis, you have 1 hour. And for y-axis, you have one box is equal to 30 kilometers. So this is your scale. That's all about this question. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Beta, you have to answer the two parts. Two questions are given. You have to answer those questions from the graph. The first part is the time taken by Ajit to ride 75 kilometers. Dekho idhar. Beta, 75. In between the 60 and 90, you have total gap is of 30. If you make half of 30, that is your 15. So that means this 60 plus 15 will give you 75. And when you join this 75, and if you join this here, you can see that from here you are having the value of x as 2.5. That means 2 hours 30 minutes. In 2 hours 30 minutes, you will cover the distance of 75 kilometers. Is it okay? So I have joined 75 kilometer on y-axis from this line, and let's join this from x-axis, and you will get the respective value of this value from x-axis, that is 2.5 hours. Next part is the distance covered by Ajit in 3.5 hour. 3.5 hour, beta, this is your 3.5 hour. If you join this line here, and if you join this line here, so you will get the value of x as x from value of y from y axis. As you can see that this is 3.5. So yahan pe aapke paas next value aayegi, that is your 120. So iske middle mein kya aayega, 90. Ye total 30 kilometer hai na, to 30 ka half kya hoga, 15. So 90 plus 15 will give you 105 kilometer. So during the time of 3.5 hour, Ajit will ride a scooter and he will cover a distance of 105 kilometers that we have seen from the graph. Answer, whether you have got the correct answer or not. So for this, you can check the values. I'm substituting the values here for you. Look here. The first part is you have given y as 75 kilometers. So let's put this value here. 75 is equal to 30x. This is 75 upon 30. Divide karke, you will get 2.5 hour. That means during 2.5 hour, the person must have covered 75 kilometers. And if you want to check the second part also, you can. Yes, I am doing here second part for you. X is your 3.5 hour. 3 2s are 6 plus 1 7 by 2. And your equation is y is equal to 30x. Let's put this value 30 into 7 by 2. This is your 15, and 15 sevens are 105. So y is equal to 105 kilometer. So during 3.5 hours, the person must have covered 105 kilometers. Got it, beta? Any doubt? Revision linear equation chapter. So let's start with this question. X by 3 plus 5 by 2 is equal to minus 3 by 2. Let us start this question. Hurry up, everybody, solve this. Yes, listen. The question is solve and check. Whether checking part is given in your book or not, but you have to check to make sure that you are getting the correct answer. So start this question. Hurry up. You please solve it. I will discuss it for you once. Hurry up. Now, you will separate out the terms that contain x. This is your x by 3 that you will write here at the same place. And this 5 by 2 is having plus sign. When you shift this term on your right hand side, it will become minus 5 by 2. So take LCM. After taking LCM, this is your minus 3 and minus 5. So this is your minus 8 by 2. This will give you minus 4. So as you can see that 3 is dividing here. When you shift this 3 on your right hand side, it will give you x is equal to minus 12. Yes, can you tell me minus 12 is called the solution of the equation? Got it, beta? As it is equation, you can see that equality sign is there, so it is called equation. Agar ye sirf aise hota, so this is called your expression. Got it? If equality sign is there, then you will say that it is your equation. If no equality sign is there, then it will be your expression. Got it? Now, this minus 12 you have got after the solution of this. So this minus 12 must be your solution of the equation. Just write this thing. After solving this, you will write minus 12 is the solution. And inside the bracket, you will write one more thing. Solution, or you can say root of the equation. Got it, beta? So this minus 12 is called the solution of the equation, or you can say it is the root of the given equation. Okay, beta? So I'm telling you the question, that the number which satisfies the given equation is called the solution or the root of the equation. Is it okay? Now, you will do the checking part. So for the checking, you will solve the left hand side and the right hand side separately. You will substitute the value of x as minus 12. So this is your minus 4 plus 5 by 2. This is your minus 8 plus 5 by 2. This will give you minus 3 by 2. And on the right hand side, you can check that it's already minus 3 by 2 given to you. So you will write here left hand side is equal to right hand side. So minus 12 is the solution of the equation, or you can say it is the root of the given equation. Question is, what should be added? So I've written x should be added to twice of this rational number to get 3 by 7 is your answer. So you will multiply this, and this term is your constant. You will shift it on the right hand side, and from here you will get the missing number. So this is your example number 5. Next is your example number 6. The perimeter of the rectangle is 13 centimeter. Perimeter is given, that is 13, and the formula for the perimeter is twice length plus breadth is equal to 13. And in this you have given width. Width means breadth, that is your 2, 3 by 5, and you have to find the length of the rectangle. So how you will solve this? So for this, I'm telling you one step. Either you can multiply this 2 with both the terms inside the bracket, or you can directly take this 2 on the right hand side. So this is your length. 2 4s are 8 plus 3, 11 by 4 is equal to 13 by 2. This is multiplying here. When you shift this on the right hand side, this is your 13 by 2. And I've written the bracket same. So here you have addition sign. When you shift this, plus 11 by 4, this will give you 13 by 2 minus 11 by 4. So after solving this, you will definitely get the length from here. Got it? And one more question can be added here. Length you will get from here. Breadth is already given, so it can be find. Area can be find from here. The question, one more question can be added to this statement also. Find the area of the figure. So you will find that by using the formula length multiplied by breadth. Got it? Now, next is example number 7. In the example number 7, you have given the present age of the Sahil mother is 3 times the present age of the Sahil. Sahil ki jo mother hai, unki age jo hai, that is 3 times the present age of the Sahil. This relation is given to you. So from here, you have listened about the complete statement, and the complete statement I have spoken the last word Sahil age. So from the last word that you have listened is Sahil's age. So you will suppose the Sahil's age first. Let the Sahil's age be X. If the Sahil's age is present age is X, then the mother's age is 3X. So mother ki age kya ho jayegi? 3X, and Sahil's age is X years. Got it, beta? So jo bhi statement mein last mein word aayega, that you will suppose first. And the next is after 5 years. After 5 years, If the present age of the Sahil is X, then what will be the age of Sahil after 5 years? So after 5 years, Sahil's age be X plus 5 and the mother age be 3X plus 5. I have just simply written them. Now according to statement, I will make it equation. So according to statement, after 5 years, so after 5 years, I have written the age of both the persons. Their age will be added to 65. Dono ki age ka jo sum hai, that is your 66. That is given in the question. Now you will solve it and you will get the value of X from here. At the end, if you will get the value of X and the value of X, that is 14. So Sahil's age is your 14. And when you put 14 here, 14 threes are 42. So his mother's age will be 42 years. Got it, beta? Any doubt? Consecutive number type ka question, main aapko ek bata deti hu. The question is the sum of the consecutive three multiples of 11 is 363. Multiples of 11. So multiples of 11 you can take as 11x, 11x plus 11, और 11x plus 22, एक तो ऐसे ले सकते हैं. यहाँ पे क्या है, 0, then 11, then 22 you can add. 11x में पहले 0, क्योंकि 11 zeros are 0 होता है, 11 ones are 11 होता है, 11 twos are 22 होता है. One way is this, or we have one another way, x, x plus 11, x plus 22. Both can be the ways. You can use any of the method. So the sum of these three numbers is 363. So I'm using this. As you can see that here I've written the number 2 times. So some little bit big calculations can be there. So I've written this. It involves small numbers and small few calculations are there. So this is your X, X plus 11 and X plus 22. That is your 363. Got it? Now solve this. X, X, X will give you 3X. And next is 33. When you subtract this, 363 minus 33 is equal to 330. So X is equal to 111. So your answer is 110. So 110, when you put here, this is your 110, this is your 121, and next is your 132. So these are the three consecutive multiples of 11 that will give you the sum as 363. Again, in example number 8, you have given, main roughly bata rahi hun aapko, kehta hai, 3 times jitne 2 rupees coins hai, number of 2 rupee coins is equal to number of 5 rupees coins. Ye kehta hai aapko. Matlab, कि जितनी भी कॉइन्स हैं आपके पास 2 रुपीज के, वो 3 times हैं 5 रुपी कॉइन के. जितने 5 रुपी, मतलब कहने का मतलब है ये यहाँ आएगा, ये मतलब है इसका. जितने 5 रुपी कॉइन्स हैं उसका अगर आप 3 times कर दो तो उतने उसके पास 2 रुपीज कॉइन्स है. दैट मीन्स, ठीक है, सो यू विल सपोज द नंबर ऑफ 5 रुपी कॉइन्स एज योर एक्स एंड द नंबर ऑफ 2 रुपीज कॉइन इज 3 times योर एक्स. तो नंबर ऑफ 5 rupee coins is X. Got it? Actually, in the statement, you have heard about the term three times as many as 2 rupee coins as he has 5 rupee coins. So, baad mein kya bola? 5 rupee coins. So, I have supposed 5 rupee coin as